Tonight, a Metro mother wants help finding the man who broke into her home while she and her children were sleeping.
It all happened near Northeast 52nd in Westminster, and Eyewitness News 5's Brandon Beyer is live with what happened when her motherly instincts kicked in. Brandon?
Well, Paul and Jessica, this mother of three young children, told herself when she realized there was an intruder in the house. She drew an imaginary line. She told herself, if he crosses that line, she'd be forced to attack.
My heart starts beating like really fast, and I'm scared and like mad at the same time because he just broke in my house. So it was like, what can you do, you know? And I just started fighting.
With her fiance already at work, Crystal Smitherman says she heard three loud bangs coming from her living room. She quickly put her twin 1-year-old sons in the room with their 3-year-old sister.
Like the loud boom again when I shut the door, and I told my daughter, don't move. Stay in
here. Crystal says despite her fear, she would stop at nothing to protect her family.
I just attacked him. What? I was just like, you're not. If I felt like he was going to get back to closer to my kids, and I just wanted to protect my kids and me.
Her aggression quickly reverses the situation, and now a would-be robber is trying to escape. Guessing the intruder didn't have a weapon, Crystal doesn't let up.
I kind of figured he didn't for the simple fact he didn't have a flashlight because he couldn't see what he was doing. So that was my, you know, first instinct. Okay, you don't really have, you're not prepared.
Just before fleeing, he did manage to stab her in the shoulder with a small screwdriver. It's an injury Crystal says she didn't realize for several minutes. And Crystal, certainly not the only hero here. The 3-year-old had taken the young children into the room and calmed them down throughout this whole ordeal. When the mom opened the door, they were all waiting patiently in one bed. We are live tonight. Brandon Beyer, Eyewitness News 5.
Scary story for the family there, Brandon. Crystal's attacker was also wearing a mask, so police don't have a good description to go on. But if you can help out, call Crime Stoppers, 235-7300.